Hi everybody. So obviously this is me after my surgery. Before you watch today's video, I want you to know what a port is. A port is a small appliance that they put inside of you and it's attached to a catheter. The catheter connects the port to a vein in your body. So when I go for chemo, instead of getting it in my arms, which I've talked about in my previous videos, because it burns your arms and it can be uncomfortable. They put a hole here and they put the catheter in through there and then the port goes here. There's like a 1-inch incision and I have a double port. They don't put you to sleep. They give you a sedative and they gave me Versed, which relaxes you and takes away all your anxiety. And they do local anesthetic and it like burns the area a little bit while it's numbing it, which is the only like real pain that you feel during this whole thing. And I don't even remember feeling that because I was so out from the Versed. I actually did end up falling asleep for a little bit and I woke up when they were stitching me. We played Regina Spektor while I got the procedure done.
Just got labs and now at the Pinnacle.
Waiting.
What are we doing?
Waiting.
What are we doing?
Patiently waiting.
What are we waiting for?
Mashiach.
For Mashiach.
We're in pre-op right now.
Just got out of surgery. My mommy. She did great. Wasn't as bad as I thought, and I fell asleep, so not much pain, but just feeling really emotional because it's really getting real. I don't even know. The quicker we do this, the quicker it's over. This is where they put the tube in, and then this is where the port is. Half hour after surgery and I'm ready to go. Right?
Yeah. You're good to go.
It's a miracle. Bionic woman.
This is Adrian, the main man.
He's the man in the bow tie.
Rachelle's writing down her website for him, so he's gonna check out the video later.
At Sylvester in Miami, leaving the port placement, there's a wall of Daisy Award winners, and Dana's on it. Hi, Dana.
5 months. Think about it. We'll be in football season. Back to the NBA season will restart already.
Lovely valet, guys, because at UM, you stay classy. I'm home. So I'm chilling here with this shit. And I had a visitor come and she gave me cool gifts, which I will show you tomorrow. She also gave me butterfly kisses from her boyfriend, Dan. And I love butterfly kisses. And I love my family. You guys are the shit. I fell asleep a little bit on the couch. And then I woke up and I wanted to go upstairs to go to sleep. I got super, super dizzy and I felt like I was fainting. I dropped to the floor very slowly, like against my mom's bed. And like I heard ringing in my ears. And I got into bed and then I just couldn't fall asleep. Can't sleep. What's new? It's just kind of uncomfortable. So itchy. Mom's getting me cool compresses. So that I don't itch it. Still can't sleep. I think it's almost 2 o'clock in the morning. I was up until maybe like 3:30. I was really uncomfortable last night. It's given that it's just gonna be uncomfortable right now. I expected that. But today I'm a lot better actually. Getting my nails painted. Hi Blake.
Hi, hi Priel.
Hi Marlene.
Hi
Bubba. These are my mom's amazing friends.
We love you.
Yeah. I was feeling really yucky and I can't shower yet.
Sponge bath.
I could do this myself, just so you guys know. Emo wants to
make you feel better.
Yeah.
Smell better.
But I'm so itchy. I actually took a Benadryl. The radiologists and his nurses kept warning me of infection and making me very paranoid about infection. So I am just very paranoid of infection now. So any like redness or itching kind of freaks me out. It's just shitty that like Hodgkin's symptoms are also symptoms of what could be an infection. You really just have to be able to know the difference.
Everything is going to be okay. Take back my life.